Hey guys, I'm Chuck, and those are my Charlie cards. And these right here, these are my fancy Charlie chips. In the town I live in, we have a happy face mode right into the side of a hill. That's why this is Happy Face Holdem. The goal, log 500 hours of 2-3 no limit Holdem, and have more Charlie chips at the end of the session than we started with. Let's get into the action. Oh yeah, baby, I'm back. After the last two vlogs here from the bicycle hotel and casino that didn't go so well, I'm sitting in the hijack in this straddled pot with pocket aces. Yeah, baby. When the action gets around to me, I'm going to put in a small raise to 18. Don't want to scare everybody out. Want to keep some action in the hand. Gets back around to the button, who four bets to 75. Wow, is that not a dream come true when you're sitting with the nuts? All right, action folds back around to me, and I got to think, do I want to just flat call or get the money in? So let's go ahead and get all of it in right now and see if the button will come along and play for the ride. I'm happy when the button snap calls. Flop comes down, gives me a set. I'm pretty happy to see that. The third spade makes my heart skip a beat, and the river's blank. When the villain flips over her pocket kings, I am relieved to see that we take down this large pot in our third hand of the night. Not a bad way to get started tonight. So they really are doing a great job down here at the Bicycle Hotel and Casino. They're sanitizing everything. Players' hands when you return to the table, when you get up. The food's phenomenal. Just doing a great job. Really enjoying the eight-handed play down here. So sitting here in middle position, I look down at Ace Jack suited. This is a great hand to put in a nice raise and thin the field out just a little bit. So when the action gets around to me, I'm going to raise it up 11 bucks. I find that a raise to 15 or 21 in this game tends to fold everybody out. So just go for a little raise of 11. Try to keep a little bit of action on the table. All right, the big blind's going to make the call here and join me. When the flop comes down completely missing us, I imagine that it's going to hit the big blind better than it hits me. Come down 8, 7, deuce, rainbow. He checks over to me, and I'm happy to check behind in case he's trying to trap me here. The turn comes down to 10 of diamonds. I figure, okay, at this point he must have missed, but some straight draws got there. But I'm going to go ahead and make a C bet here for 12 bucks, and that's going to be enough for the big blind to wave the flag. And let us chip up. Gotta love stacking up those Charlie chips. So far, we're up on the session. We're a couple hours in at this point. Next hand here, I'm sitting in the big blind, another straddled pot. We have one or two players that seem to be straddling regularly tonight. The gal that I took the big pot from earlier has already left the game. So from the big blind, I look down here at Ace 7 offsuit. Playing with a hand like this is if it's raised before it gets back around to me, I'm just going to dump this hand. Not a very playable hand at all. Nice to have an ace, but with a 7 kicker, you never know what you're going to run into, and actually get you in a lot of trouble. So when it's limped all the way back around to me, I'll go ahead and throw in the extra 3 bucks from the big blind to make the call. If the straddler raises, again, I'll dump the hand, but I figured I'm getting a good price to stick around. So when the end of the gun checks, we're going to go see a flop. Always an alternative here to go ahead and pump it up big and thin the pot, but not going to happen here. So when the flop comes down, 10, jack, 5, all suited hearts, I'm going to check. Under the gun checks, and the action continues to check all the way around. Nobody wants to take a stab at this pot, and I don't blame them. With 18 in the pot, the turn comes down, the queen of spades, I check. Under the gun checks. And this is going to be enough for the small blind to bet out $25. So he overbets the pot. There's a straight draw, a flush draw. I'm imagining he hit his straight and wanted to protect against the flush. So sitting here in the hijack, I look down at pocket fives. A small pocket pair, middle pocket pair are great for set mining, meaning I'm willing to play the hand as long as I can stand a chance to win 10 times the initial raise. So looking around at the other player stacks, they all have over 180 each. So I stand to make at least 10 times this $18 raise. So I put in that amount, and we're going to go to a flop with $59 in the pot, hoping to hit a set. So dealer puts out for us. 8, 6, 5, two spades. We hit our set. We're loving life right now. There's a straight draw on the board, two to the flush, which is a little unnerving. I want to keep a little bit of action around. I don't want to scare everybody away. Take my chances here that I can make a little more money. So I put in about a half pot size bet of 30. Unfortunately, nobody wants to stick around. The action folds around. The good news, the stack of Charlie chips grows. And so far, we're on our way to a good night and a winning session. All right, continuing on to the next hand here. I'm getting a little bit tired. Worked a long day. The session's running long. You notice we haven't had any big pots. Everything's kind of a flop, bet, fold. Not seeing much to the river. I'm getting sleepy. I tend to play with my cards this way when I'm getting a little bit tired. So I look down with ace four suited. You know, in this raised pot from the big blind, this is the place where I should three bet and thin the field a little bit. But I am a little bit tired, probably not thinking straight, and I do opt just for the call of $18. So we're going to go three ways to the flop. And can you believe it? The miracle 2, 3, 5 of clubs. So I'm going to check. Hope that our original raiser induces some action, which he does. Under the gun, two bets. And I wake up from my dream. It was Jack King 7 with two diamonds on the board. Totally missed us with one over. No reason to continue here. I'm going to wave the flag, surrender, and realize that it's probably time for a nap. So here we go. We changed seats. New player in seat 3. He's gone all in the last two hands. He's talking smack. I can hardly understand him with his broken English. I look down at 6-7 of hearts from the hijack. So I'm going to raise it up just a little bit here. It's in the field. And lo and behold, the cutoff goes all in once again for over 300. Yeah, can I get a table change? I'm not the only one that was frustrated with this guy. So I take a break. I go outside, go for a walk. And I come back from my break and look down from under the gun at Jack 9 suited. I'm going to play for my full stack here. So I'm going to limp in and see what this player to my left does. See if he goes all in again. He does raise to $20. We have one caller down at the other end of the table, and the action's going to fold back around to me, and I'm just going to fold. It's time for that table change. I give up. Wasn't able to do any live recording after this, so we'll review two more hands from the studio.
Hey guys, like I said, had to change tables, couldn't deal with that guy next to me anymore. So I'm over to a new table. There were no power outlets on this table, so I wasn't able to record my hands. So a couple hands that I want to go over here. So in the first hand I have, I look down at 5-6 offsuit on the button. When the action checks around to me, I raise it up to 12. This is just a 4x bet. Figure I'm on the button, I have position, I have initiative, and I have the chips. So here we go. Middle position calls, everybody else folds. Flop comes down, king, 6, deuce with two spades on the board. Middle position checks to me. He was the original caller. And I go ahead and throw out a bet of 15 here. And that's going to be enough to win the hand. Like I said earlier, a lot of this was just, flop, bet, fold. Flop, bet, fold. We didn't see a lot of, 2 and 3 bet pots. I didn't see a lot of 3 or 4 betting pre-flop. Really ABC poker tonight. And I'm not sure there's a whole lot of money to be made. So hey guys, I want to chat real quick about a hand I didn't record, King 10 offsuit. I was on the button and I had raised it up just a little bit because there wasn't any preflop action. Another player in late position, when it came back around to him, raised it up pretty significantly, probably a 10x. I think he made it 40, 45 bucks. So my King 10, I called. The flop comes out 10 high and he puts out a significant bet. I remember just about folding, and I should have, because why am I playing King 10 to begin with? But I figure now I'm committed. I got top pair with second kicker, so I go ahead and make the call. Anyways, the flop and the river don't change anything, and he turns over pocket jack. So, watch out playing King 10. Not a great hand to be playing. Anyway, so that's my advice. Don't play King 10. So on this next hand, I have ace 10 offsuit from under the gun, and I went ahead and raised it up to 10 bucks. Just a small raise. Again, I said earlier, anything over $11 or $12, everybody was folding pre-flop. Really ABC small dollar poker here. So the flop comes down with three callers, by the way. The flop comes down ace, 9, 7 with two spades on the board. I'm first to act under the gun. I bet out 25 and under the gun calls. So I'm a little nervous with my 10 kicker here, but I'm going to stay my line. I'm going to play aggressive and just see how this goes. The turn comes down a queen of spades. So now there's a made flush draw on the board. I went ahead and repped the flush. I bet out 45 and under the gun went ahead and called. So the guy that's left in the hand, now I got to think to myself, you know, what range is he on? Is he ace, king, ace, queen? You know, he called my small raise in late position. So I'm playing this out of position. And when that made flush draw came, you know, I tried to bet it out like I had it, and he's calling me. So the river comes with four hearts, and I have to make a decision now. You know, I got over $100 in the pot. I'm looking at this player. He wasn't a very strong player. I think I think his face told a lot, and he looked a little bit nervous, and he was running short on chips. He had about 80 in his stack. So rather than put them all in, I made a small, tried to make it look like more of a value bet out $60 here. I think if I jam, he calls me right away. So I make a value bet of 60. Figuring I have some showdown value with my aces, although I have a weak kicker. And it's good enough that he's going to fold this hand. Pretty excited about that. All right, so the night wasn't all Twinkies and roses for me here. I did lose a lot of pots on the way. I made two bluffs, and I got looked up, and it just didn't go well for me. I did win a bomb pot. It was my second only ever bomb pot I played in. I was dealt 10-3. We were seven of the eight players agreed to play. Player in seat three, Corona Steve is what I call him. He was falling asleep. He was hacking like he had the Corona. Just wasn't a good scene. So the flop comes down, king 7-3. I got bottom pair. Hey, not bad. Action checks around. We got 70 in the pot. The turn come a queen of spades, and early position player bet out $25. And I got to think, you know, with a bottom pair, I need about 12-1 to make the call here. And I'm getting about 8-1, maybe 6-1. So, hey, what the heck? Let's make the call, 25. And the miracle three comes. I hit my two outer on the river, and I have trip threes. And that's going to be good enough for me to bet 50 on the river and good enough to take this pot down. So that was a nice win. One last hand that I played in, I had king jack offsuit on the button. And seat three down there, Corona Steve, he was all night. He would limp and then call a raise. Limp, call a raise. He'd check, call. So limp, call, check, call. Never raise, never bet. So when he's the only one that limped into this pot, I'm on the button. I figure I'm going to go ahead and raise it up. So I raise it up to $12 or $13. And small and big blinds fold. And Corona Steve go ahead and makes the call. Flop comes down, ace 10-3, and Corona Steve checks. I have a straight draw, but I go ahead and make a decent size three-quarter pot bet here. I think I'm going to get him off his hand. He thinks about it for a little bit, and he calls. The turn's a blank. I check for pot control, and the river comes down a blank as well. The only way I'm going to take this pot is if I jam. So I put in 95, which is his whole stack. So I put him all in. He thought about it forever, forever. And he makes the call. He's got bottom pair. He's got a pair of three. So I totally missed, and he looked up my bluff, and it caught me. So anyways, guys, although all the hands I reviewed tonight, looks like I won most of them. It was a long session. I worked all day. I did leave the night down 206. So I'm 0-3 at the Bicycle Hotel Casino. So as I move into the studio to finish up this vlog, although I played this session over the weekend, it is Wednesday, July 1st today, and I just got done listening to Governor Gavin Newsom, California's governor, and he has closed Cardrooms for a minimum of 3 weeks. So we got Cardrooms, indoor dining, and family entertainment centers, and those sorts of things, all closed for the next 3 weeks. So I'm glad that I got these hands in, these sessions in while I could, while things were open and still active. I'm going to miss you. I'm going to miss you. But hey, guys, no sweat. I'll take a break from vlogging like I did before. You know, I started this vlog right before the pandemic hit. Had to stop. Came back out. Got a couple vlogs in here. Pretty excited to get down to the bicycle and play some cards. And was going to go down tonight, actually, and play a session. And it's not going to happen. So, hey, guys, if you've liked this vlog content as much as I've liked bringing it to you, please do me a big favor. Give this video a thumbs up down below. Smash that thumbs up. Hit the subscribe button, so make sure you get all my videos in your feed. And don't forget to ring that bell, because that bell will make sure that you're notified of any new content that I drop. I've really enjoyed the comments, I've really enjoyed the interaction, and I don't feel so alone in the poker realm having you guys out there. So it's been kind of nice to have you all chat with. And I'm looking forward to doing it more.